Right now at 10, the La Crosse School Board adopting a resolution to put school consolidation on this November ballot.
And two elementary students are dead tonight following a horrific incident in Middleton.
Plus, a local jail is getting some much-needed renovations. We're on site to see how they plan to upgrade their facilities.
Watching WKBT La Crosse, this is News 8 Now at 10.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us for News 8 Now at 10. I'm Ken Kozarowski.
And I'm Emily Brown.
The La Crosse School Board plans to put the consolidation of Emerson and Spence Elementary Schools up to the voters this November. Board Member Juan Jimenez motioned for a vote to approve that resolution about 2 hours into tonight's board meeting, and that passed with almost the full board's support. Now, a referendum would essentially ask voters to support combining Emerson and Spence at the Hogan Administrative Center site. The two schools' age and large upcoming maintenance costs were large factors in the decision, but several board members were also hesitant about such a referendum passing because of Emerson's passionate neighborhood. Before the vote, some members asked for Facilities Director Joe Ledvina's input.
The Spence-Emerson makes the most sense. I know this is cost avoidance that we talk about in these buildings, but they're very real. And so every day, yes, we're avoiding costs by doing that, but at some point, we're going to have to invest that money.
As we have previously reported, board members say the district will have more closure decisions to make to get out from under a multi-million dollar deficit. And because of that, the board could decide at future meetings to add more to this potential referendum question.
Three people are dead, including two Sauk Trail Elementary School students, and one more was injured in a homicide that happened Sunday night in Middleton. According to police, Middleton police officers arrived on scene in the 6300 block of Maywood Avenue around 7:40 p.m. Sunday for a check property complaint related to this incident. When they arrived, a man exited the residence saying he was shot multiple times.
So I was just like, you know, on a call with some friends. I was gonna go to one of my friend's house, and I just heard like gunshots, like 6 or 7 gunshots go off, and I also heard a guy scream.
Additional law enforcement were called to the scene, including the Dane County Sheriff's Office. When officers made it into the residence, three people were found dead. The Middleton Cross Plains Area School District confirmed two of the deceased were students at Sauk Trail Elementary School.
The battle for redistricting legislative maps in the state of Wisconsin is over. Today, Governor Tony Evers signing into law maps that he personally drew and submitted to the Supreme Court, saying they, quote, reflect the will of the people. This new change means elections will now reflect how a purple Wisconsin will see new names on their ballots this fall. The state Supreme Court tossed the state's legislative district maps back in December and asked the legislature to find an agreement over how districts are defined going forward. Representative Jill Billings, who represented the La Crosse area for a decade, says with these new maps incoming, she now has some new faces to represent.
I hope folks will take the time to really understand before they go to the polls who's running in their districts, because things will be changing. I will not have the entire city of La Crosse under my seat anymore.
The signed bill says the new maps will take effect for this year's general election, but not any special elections that come before that. And the governor is asking the Supreme Court for clarification on that amendment.
A mental health awareness event is teaching children and parents of Osseo Fairchild School District about the resources available to anyone suffering a crisis. The free community event took place at Osseo High School. Mental health professionals in the community shared information on various resources on a variety of mental health topics. Dr. Julie Bates-Maves gave a presentation on the brain and coping and regulation skills that are helpful when feeling distressed. A school counselor says the winter time can be especially challenging for those struggling with their mental health.
We've been seeing an increase in mental health concerns in the last, I would say, 5 years, and especially in the winter time in February, we have noticed the most. So that's why we try to have this in February to just get more information and more resources out.
Now, this is Osseo's third mental health awareness event. Their goal is to get as much information out to the community as possible.
The Crawford County Jail held an open house for the public this afternoon for their replacement project.
The open house gave citizens the chance to get more details on the renovations from the commissioners of the project. News 8 Now's Shaquille Davis was there and has more on the story. Shaq?
Ken, Emily, after the open house, I was lucky enough to get a tour and see what the old jail looked like and see why the new jail is needed. Things such as air circulation and plumbing need upgrades.
Every part of it needs to be upgraded. it's the space.
Scott elaborates in saying that the old jail just doesn't fit the new state standards and codes for jails. It's also not ADA accessible.
American Disabilities Act, so you'll see that when you go up some of the narrow stairways, the handrails aren't correct. So you start to see all those deficiencies that it doesn't meet today's standards or codes.
He has been doing this kind of work for years and says jail renovations are all too familiar with him.
We've done probably about 400 jail studies and projects throughout the Midwest.
He also says the biggest thing that he wants you to know about the design is that it caters to the needs of the people, not the wants. And this starts with being cost conscious.
But when you look at the total project cost of the facility, you start to see that the construction is one piece of it, but the staffing that goes into it over a 30-year lifespan can be very expensive.
Many times, 10% of the 30-year budget goes towards the construction, with operational costs like staffing and utilities making up 90% of the budget.
So really what we're trying to do is get a very staff-efficient layout so that we can limit the staff, which is the biggest driver of the total cost in the grand scheme of things.
This project is costing around $30 million, asking to borrow $10 million three different times over the next 2 years while they construct it, in hopes of taking advantage of a better interest rate market.
And so I think it's probably scheduled for about 20 months of construction. So I don't think we're going to get it done in time in 2025, but probably beginning of 26.
All the commissioners are hoping to start the construction this upcoming September. Also, they will be doing the little things such as finding different building materials to keep the costs down. Ken and Emily.
All right, Shaquille Davis live in studio. Thank you, Shaq.
Mourners left flowers on police and fire vehicles and hugged each other outside the Burnsville Police Department in Minnesota today. After three first responders were killed at a home in suburban Minneapolis early Sunday, the two police officers and paramedic were killed during a standoff in Burnsville by a heavily armed man who shot at police from the home where seven children were also inside. The suspect is dead and another police officer was injured in the shooting. Investigators are still putting together details of the shooting, which unfolded from a domestic call.
The next state in the race to lock in the GOP nomination is South Carolina, where polls open on Saturday for the primary. Republican candidate Nikki Haley used President's Day to meet as many voters as possible in her home state. Haley is trailing in the polls by double digits, but she is downplaying the possibility of a win, saying instead she wants to be competitive. Haley has been sharpening her attacks on former President Trump's foreign policy, while the former president is focused on his various legal battles.
To keep on doing what we're doing. We've got people excited in South Carolina. They're ready to vote. They've already started early voting. We'll see what happens on Saturday, and then on Sunday we're headed to Michigan.
The judges and prosecutors that were dealing with me are essentially all the same, different wrappings, tone, manner, but always the same coordinated and overly nasty result. They are nasty.
Former President Trump acknowledged the death of Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny for the first time today, mentioning Navalny in a social media post before quickly transitioning to talking about his court cases. Haley responded on social media, pointing out that Trump failed to condemn Russian President Vladimir Putin. A new series of storms is hitting Southern California.
How more than 30 million residents are dealing with flood warnings and the dangers these storms are expected to bring in the next few days.
News 8 Now and Dairyland Power Cooperative present the Community Calendar.
Celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Upper Mississippi Natural Wildlife and Fish Refuge with a visit from Will Dilg and scenes from our mighty Mississippi with Stephen Marking, February 22nd and 23rd at the Pump House. The UWL Jazz Orchestra will get dancers moving with swing, Latin, and contemporary tunes for a big band cabaret and dance party at the UWL Student Union, February 23rd.
For more information on these events, or if you'd like to submit an event, visit news8000.com.
There's no better time to get started on your 2024 outdoor living project than the 2024 Early Bird Home Show, which is only at the Board Store. Visit our showroom, explore the possibilities, patio covers, operable pergolas. For year-round living, consider the cabin room or the more traditional room. Stop in, arrange for a prompt free estimate on your 2024 outdoor living project during the 2024 Early Bird Home Show, only at the Board Store.
At Toma Health Cardiac and Pulmonary Rehab, we take your treatment to heart.
Here at Toma Health, we offer both phase two cardiac rehab, pulmonary rehab, and supervised exercise therapy for patients with peripheral artery disease.
We give them essentially the tools to go off on their own. It's a goal to the program, right? Is to get back to doing what you love to do.
Since I've been doing this, I feel great. Oh, I would definitely recommend Toma Health.
Toma Health, together in care.
Another atmospheric river is hitting California tonight, and it's bringing possible flooding, mudslides, hail, and even tornadoes to most of the state.
CBS News correspondent Dina Demetrius reports from Los Angeles.
This creek in Santa Barbara County is now a raging river after intense rains, flooding a bike path and tearing away some pavement.
We're counting in the 6 to 7 inches of rain up in the foothills at this point. So all that water has to come downstream.
That means into the city of Santa Barbara, where sandbags and barricades are protecting properties. The flooded airport was shut down. A rescue team responded to one area after a CBS News crew saw a body in the water. What happened is still unclear.
Whether this was somebody walking near a creek or somebody that was living in a creek or somebody that tripped and fell in, we just don't know at this point.
The storm also toppled trees in the area. In Alameda County, part of Route 84 broke off. Farther south, there was more flooding in Ventura County.
The roads are very hazardous, plus there's some flooding in the lower lying areas. So again, we like to urge people to stay off the roads if they can.
The storm is hitting as cleanup is still underway from the last atmospheric river, including a landslide that destroyed a home and cars in a Los Angeles neighborhood. Almost 40 million people are under weather alerts, with more rain in the forecast. Dina Demetrius, CBS News, Los Angeles.
Now in the Sierra, there is a winter storm warning until Wednesday with possible blizzard conditions.
Well, are you looking for a close-up view of the total solar eclipse in April?
Coming up, how one local aircraft is giving you a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to catch the not-so-bright spectacle.
And we have mild temperatures for the next several days, even some great sunsets with all the cloud cover that'll be out there, the high cloud cover. I'll break down what our temperatures look like throughout the next weekend, and if we have a chance for rain coming next week. All that I'll break down coming up on your First Morning Weather Update after the break.
Walt never smoked a day in his life, so when he developed a bad cough, we never thought lung cancer, but that's what it was. What gives a non-smoker lung cancer? A friend suggested we check the house for radon. Sure enough, it was high. We've had it taken care of now, but I wish we'd known sooner. Walt died 4 weeks and 5 days after the diagnosis. If you haven't had your home checked for radon, do it. Do it for your family. No one should lose someone they love because of this.
What I love about T-Mobile is that just about anywhere you go, you're gonna have coverage.
Where I live is a rural area. The coverage has been awesome.
Reliable coverage is super important for me, for my business.
And after investing billions to light up our network from big cities to small towns, T-Mobile is America's largest and fastest 5G network. See for yourself. Try T-Mobile's network free for 3 months. Your phone, our network, no strings.
At Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, we know children, which is why we strive to make every visit to the dentist a positive experience. Our gentle, friendly approach is why we've been providing care for over 25 years. Whether it's routine cleanings, sealants, fluoride, or cavities and crowns, we have the gentle hands to make your children comfortable. At Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, we are here to help your children start a lifetime of healthy dental habits.
Rugabilitility. We straight made that word up. How else to describe the otherwise indescribable, rugged, capable, incredible versatility and affordability of a Honda SUV? Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com calls Honda the best value brand. Car and Driver calls Honda the winningest brand in 10 best history. But we like ruggability, and you'll like the Incredifantabulous deals, so see your Wisconsin Heartland Honda dealer today. Honda gets Wisconsin.
I'm Kelly Wilde. It's 102.7 WKBH. When my grandmother passed away, my mom gifted me with her Bohemian cookbook. I found one recipe for a soup, and written on top of it in my grandmother's beautiful handwriting was, "She really loves this." So I cook up a small batch, bring it over to my mom, and she says, "What is this?" I said, "It's your favorite soup from Grandma Paulda's cookbook." Then my mom said she would make this for her dog Ginger when she couldn't go to the bathroom.
Proper installation of your new windows make a difference. The team at Clear Choice Window and Home Solutions are factory trained to make sure your windows are installed to last. Call or stop into the showroom for your free estimate.
Thank you for watching News 8 Now. Expect more.
The Wall Street Journal reports Capital One is buying Discover Financial Services, citing people familiar with the matter.
The deal would combine two of the largest credit card companies in the United States. The Journal reports the all-stock deal could be announced as early as tomorrow. Capital One has a market value of more than $52 billion. Discover's market value is $28 billion. The merger would be one of the biggest mergers this year.
Capital One uses MasterCard and Visa for most of its cards. The Journal reports Capital One plans to switch at least some of them to the Discover network and keep the Discover brand. Want a very up close and personal view of a total solar eclipse? Well, a Delta flight this spring will provide that opportunity.
Delta Airlines is offering a special flight from Austin, Texas to Detroit, Michigan on April 8th. Delta Flight 1218 will be specifically operated on an A2-2300, an aircraft with extra large windows. The flight is timed for the best chance of safely viewing the solar eclipse at its peak, spending as much time as possible directly within the path of totality. Well, Starbucks has opened its first cafe designed to give customers with disabilities more store accessibility.
This Washington, D.C. location includes features like softer indoor lighting to minimize glare, shadow patterns and backlighting to help people read menu items or in-store info. It's built with materials that minimize background noise or echoes, which could disrupt people using hearing aids, and lower counters where coffee and food is placed for pickup for wheelchair access. All renovated and new cafes will implement the new design features.
Well, if you got outside today, good for you, because it was absolutely lovely, and apparently we have plenty of more of those days ahead of us.
Absolutely. Love to hear the sound of that. Just how many days, though, for the answer? Let's head over to Greg.
Yeah, I was too excited for these 40-degree days that I misspelled degrees. So if you notice that, it should be an E there instead of there. But 40-degree days, basically how many days we've had this winter, and that is December, January, and February, which we're coming to an end here. How many days we've been above 40 degrees? And so far, La Crosse, 35, that's sixth. Eau Claire, 40th. We are tied, actually, for the first spot. We'll break that tomorrow, too. La Crosse could finish high as maybe number three. The number one winter is 1887 to 88. That's for 52 days. So definitely it is very mild conditions, as we have you probably already felt throughout the whole month of January, February, too. If you look at throughout what we're looking at for the forecast for the next all the way through probably the middle of March, you can see 6 to 10, 8 to 14. And as we get up to middle of March, really the common theme is confidence pretty high. We're going to stay above average. How much still yet to be determined. Precipitation-wise, we do have a chance to see above average precipitation, but that confidence is lower, and we're going to see some of that, but really the main common theme is going to be those warmer temps. For the next several days, we're just going to see high cloud cover come through, a little weak systems here and there. There are going to be some periods of cloud cover, a little bit of a wind change, but really not much else besides temperatures will remain fairly consistent. By the noon hour, we should be in the mid-40s. We'll see more sun in the afternoon. You'll wake up with the cloud cover, and then we'll see really more sun throughout most of the area. We'll climb up to the upper 40s, low 50s. By tomorrow evening, we're going to see another system pass through, so another round of cloud cover, high cloud cover, through about this tomorrow evening. That'll pass through, and then as you wake up Wednesday morning, we're going to see temperatures once again, upper 20s, low 30s. So that's kind of what we're seeing, really common theme as these weak little systems come through for pretty much throughout Thursday. Bigger picture shows you, here comes another one. There's Wednesday, and then as we go through Thursday, Wednesday evening, we're going to start seeing a little bit of a change come Thursday. A front to the north is going to start pulling southward as we get towards Thursday evening and then Friday. Behind that, that'll probably give us some cooler air and cooler air for just Friday, and that's what we're going to kind of see. No precipitation is expected with that front, but it will drop the temperatures a little bit. But as you see, by Thursday, still well above average, and then by Friday, you see some of that pink kind of slim back to the west a little bit. We lose a little bit of that. That means our temperatures do come down a little bit, but we rebound right back quickly on the backside going into Saturday and Sunday. We're going to see 20 to 25 once again above average. So temperatures back in the 50s, definitely by Sunday of the weekend, maybe even Saturday for a few spots, and that'll continue. If you're looking for rain, it's not really until we get on next week, early next week, after we get those warm temperatures Sunday and Monday, we're going to see a system come up this way. Now, a lot of it has to be, you know, we're still about 7 days out to this, so this could change. But this looks to be a pretty significant system, at least wet-wise, precipitation-wise, and we'll track it here as we get towards Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of next week. The good news right now, we seem to be on the warm side of this, so rain would be the choice of precipitation. But until then, we're not going to see any type of rain or snow going on for tonight. We're looking at upper 20s, low 30s, few passing clouds, otherwise fairly mild conditions for this time of the year. And tomorrow, we're seeing more 50s showing up with more sun in the afternoon, mid-40s to the north. Once again, very mild conditions as we go to Thursday and to Friday. You see that drop in the temperatures behind a front, and then we'll rebound very quickly for the weekend. In fact, we could be in the upper 50s by Sunday, and then that system approaches Monday and Tuesday. We actually could see some 60s come Monday and breezy conditions with that system approaching. So, yeah, like I said, it's mild conditions continue.
Sure do.
Get the sunscreen out, like get the shades out, like you said earlier.
Sure. Yeah. Thanks, Greg. Coming up next in sports, the Brewers locking up one of their crucial arms for the next two seasons. Plus, it was rivalry night at Central High. Riverhawks and Rangers going head-to-head for the second time this season. Rob is up next.
This is you, one place to the next. One more thing to check off the list. But stopping for 30 minutes? Well, that's just not an option. So that's why there's this, the News 8000 app. All your local news, plus a little bit beyond. So take a break when you want to.
Hi, folks. Harvey Wood of Wood Sales and Service here. If you're looking for a tractor, stop by Wood Sales and check out our lineup of Coyote tractors. Subcompact, compact, and utility tractors. If it needs doing, Coyote tractors will get it done. Get 0% for 84 months or cash rebates with standard rate options. Coyote tractors at Wood Sales and Service. Experience the Wood Sales advantage of service before and after the sale. Wood Sales and Service, Black River Falls. Family owned and operated for 55 years. WoodSalesService.com.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks to help grow businesses, communities, families. A legacy of capability and technology that's made Ford F-Series America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of Built Ford Tough.
Get 2.9% financing for 72 months plus up to $2,000 in total savings on a 2023 Ford F-150 only at your local Northland Ford dealers.
It's time to vote for Best of La Crosse County. Pick your favorites in each category now through all of February. We'll announce all of the winners on April 1st. Vote for this business today on bestoflacrossecounty.com.
Presented by River Valley Remodelers.
Holman, Onalaska, and La Crosse. Cordell's Automotive is now even easier to find near you. Which location will you visit? Being family-owned, we get what it takes to truly care for your vehicle the same way you care for those you love. Schedule an appointment and let us help you know you're safe.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum. Spectrum Internet offers speed and reliability, while advanced Wi-Fi gives you best-in-class security for all your connected devices. And Spectrum Mobile delivers unlimited talk, text, and data with nationwide 5G included. Switch now and get Spectrum Internet for $49.99, plus advanced Wi-Fi and one Spectrum Mobile Unlimited line free for 12 months. Start saving today. Visit Spectrum.com, a Spectrum store, or scan to call now.
Covering all of the exciting action from your community, here's News 8 Now's Rob Schiff.
The Wisconsin boys basketball playoff brackets are officially set. Teams will tip off the postseason next Tuesday, but bragging rights were on the line tonight in La Crosse with two rivals looking for a big momentum booster before the playoffs begin. Let's head out to Central High. Riverhawks playing host to rival Logan. Home team red hot early from downtown. Henry Meyer puts Central up by six. Rangers hit right back though. Other end, Gabe Weber's wide open, corner pocket. He knocks it down. Logan within two. Riverhawks respond. What a night for Peyton Strittmatter. He had 7 threes on the night. There's one of them. Rangers call timeout. Central takes an 8-point lead. When play resumes, Meyer goes right back to work. Strong finish off the glass. But here come the Rangers on the break. Nick Jolly finds Jacob Hackbarth. Watch out. The junior throws it down. Logan down 11 at the break. Second half, Meyer making some history. The senior eclipsing the 1,000-point milestone in his high school career. Nice moment for Meyer as he gets a standing ovation from the Central faithful. Meyer's teammates having a big night as well. Strittmatter with 26 on the night. How about Noah Dingle? His corner three is going to rattle home. Central goes up by 19, but the star of the night, Henry Meyer, the senior, finishing with a game-high 35 points on the night. Central storms past the rival Rangers, 76-57. Over to West Salem now. Panthers hosting rival Westby. First half action, the senior Tamarian Henderson getting the rock early, putting it up from deep. Nothing but net. Panthers and Norse would go back and forth early on. Later in the half, Kyle Healy gets it in the corner, makes a defender fly, arcs it high into the bottom of the net. We're tied at 13. Then it's Caleb Johnson at the buzzer. He's going to drill it to put the Norse down just 3 at the break. First play of the second half, Nathan Carr setting the tone early, nailing the corner 3. Panthers go up by 6. Then it's Carr again, the junior, putting on a show, putting his defender through a spin cycle before getting the floater to drop. Panthers pull away as they get the win, 78-50. What a week it's going to be for our high school athletes, especially the girls. Regionals tipping off tomorrow night from our basketball squads. When it comes to the mat, the mission of Madison has been fulfilled for 2 girls on the Westby wrestling team. Kylie Klum is heading back to Madison for the second straight season as the sophomore makes it back-to-back trips as a state qualifier. But she's not going alone. Kylie will be joined by her cousin Marissa Klum as the junior qualified for the state tournament in just her first year ever competing on the mat. Both girls tell me that their connection has been a big part of their success so far. Being able to push one another throughout the season has helped them get to this point. They say they cannot wait until Thursday.
Oh, it's amazing. I'm so glad that she joined wrestling, and it's great to have like another girl come with me this year. Having her around, she pushes me to be a better wrestler because she's good in like certain positions that I'm not like the best at, and so she helps me improve in those spots.
She went to state her freshman year, so I was like, oh my gosh, she could do that. This is my first year, maybe I can do something great. She's stronger in areas where I'm not. There are some areas where she could improve, and we kind of use those together to help each other.
Can't wait to see how these two do. Kylie and Marissa will be making their way to Madison Thursday morning for the individual state tournament. Well, baseball season's right around the corner. Milwaukee making sure that when Brandon Woodruff is finally healthy, he'll be back on the mound in a Brewers uniform. Woody and the crew agreeing to a 2-year deal on Monday. Now, the big right-hander is expected to miss most of, if not all, of the 2024 season. The 31-year-old underwent shoulder surgery this offseason. He made just 11 starts last year. The 2-time All-Star was drafted back in 2014 by Milwaukee. He's got a career 3.1 ERA so far with the crew, spanning back to 2017. We got Ken in some throwing motion. We got
doing a little,
Emily
doing a little
doing a swing. We are ready for baseball, but not so fast. We got a lot of basketball this week.
I know.
Playoffs tip off tomorrow. I'm excited. I can't
wait. I've been itching for the MLB season.
Me too.
Like, Brewers have so many young guys that you don't really know if they're going to pan out or not. So it's that mystery that's getting me all excited.
And I think, honestly, it's one of the only sports we have left where, I mean, not any team can win. But
sure.
There's so much parity. Whereas, like, with football, we kind of know. Basketball,
yes.
We kind of know. Baseball, it's always a crapshoot.
Absolutely. You know? But hopes are high for the Brewers this year. It's a wide open division.
Let's go.
Thanks,
Rob. Go Brewers. More news after this.
We've done many, many renovations. We bought an old house and have made it into an up-to-date house. Whenever anything involves plumbing, the first call I make is to Maxwell White. Their technicians put together a great final product.
All the Taco Tuesday excitement at Taco John's can really start to mix things up. Just look at these delicious simmering Tuesdays. And on this taco, Tuesdays are only $1.19. See you on Taco at Tuesday John's. Taco John's.
Discover new opportunities together in a new Chevy. Meet up in an award-winning Equinox. Lend a hand in the Silverado with up to 14 available camera views. Or or mix it up in the tracks with an 11-inch diagonal display screen. Find the Chevy that's right for you. Drive yours away this President's Day weekend. Get 2.9% financing on all Silverado 1500 models. Or get $5,000 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Visit hometownchevy.com.
Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin invites you to experience the thrill of gaming like never before. With six locations across the state, there's something for everyone. Whether you're a slots enthusiast, a poker pro, or prefer the excitement of table games, we've got you covered. Plus, indulge in delicious dining options, live entertainment, and exclusive promotions that add even more excitement to your visit. Come join the fun at Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin.
President's Day is a time to honor all presidents, past and present. And at King Furniture, we're giving you the opportunity to save some presidents with huge discounts throughout the entire store, up to 60% off.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
And right now, you can get 0% financing.
So save some presidents at King.
For the record, Franklin was not a president, but you can save him too. It's the President's Day sale going on right now at King Furniture.
Nice people.
Nice furniture.
Nice style.
This adorable shelter pet wants to meet you and your family today. The News 8 Now Pet of the Week is brought to you by Wisconsin Veterinary Orthopedics.
Whether it's a bathroom remodel or comprehensive plumbing services, we at Maxwell White strive to keep our neighbors safe and comfortable in their homes, offering honest, upfront pricing on every service, all backed by a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Call Maxwell White today.
Expect more from News 8 Now. Thanks.
A milestone anniversary for Tina Turner. Rhino Records announces a 4-CD plus DVD edition of the soundtrack album, What's Love Got to Do With It?
The expanded release features remixes, rarities, and a 2-disc live performance. Single and double disc editions, along with digital and vinyl versions, will also arrive on April 26th. So mark your calendars, everybody. If you need some Christmas gifts, there they are. We'll be right back after this.
The model year-end clearance is going on now at Doll Auto. We have 80 2023s in stock, and it's time for them to go. You'll get exceptional savings, plus financing as low as 0%. Hurry to Doll Auto today.
Want to test drive U.S. Cellular's network free for 30 days?
Yeah.
Use this app. Want to do it even faster?
Here we go.
Oh, wow. U.S. Cellular works great out here. Still have 5G here too. I wonder if US Cellular lets me stream in my rec room. Yep, it's working. Hey, thanks for the lift.
Test drive US Cellular's award-winning network free for 30 days.
The 2024 Early Bird Home Show is your opportunity to transform the exterior of your home into something truly better than new. New seamless steel siding or attractive vinyl siding, new soffit, fascia, gutters, and window trim. Even new windows and doors will make your home better than new. Call, visit, or reach out online for a prompt free estimate on transforming the exterior of your home during the 2024 Early Bird Home Show, only at the Board Store.
At Toma Health Cardiac and Pulmonary Rehab, we take your treatment to heart.
Here at Toma Health, we offer both phase 2 cardiac rehab, pulmonary rehab, and supervised exercise therapy for patients with peripheral artery disease. We give them essentially the tools to go off on their own. That's the goal to the program, right? Is to get back to doing what you love to do.
Since I've been doing this, I feel great. Oh, I would definitely recommend Toma Health.
Toma Health, together in care.
Must have been hard to adjust with everything going on.
Didn't know how to air your grievances.
Maybe things got too heated.
Or the cost of running was too high.
All right, I did it, okay? I don't know what I'm doing. I need an expert.
I've heard all I needed to. Great job, Brooke. Read him his rights.
You have the right to a great company with over 50 years of combined experience.
That's just a matter of conditioning.
G&T, closing the case on all your heating and air conditioning needs.
Your car is worth more, $500 more, when you sell it to Dahl Auto. We'll give you an exceptional offer for your current vehicle, plus up to $500 over book value. Get more at Dahl Auto.
All right, tomorrow, once again, mild conditions. We should top 50, maybe a couple degrees above with a few clouds here and there, but more sun in the afternoon for La Crosse and south. A little bit cooler up to north, a little more clouds, but still 46. Once again, very mild conditions, and that will continue through Thursday with a slight cool down behind a cold front. We're talking down to 40 and then ramping it back up for the weekend with 50s likely by Sunday.
Okay, I like what I see.
Okay. I saw that Tina Turner in my head.
What's love got to do with it? We'll see you guys tomorrow.